just nobody here anymore. All these villages are empty. It's worrying that they've been abandoned during this agricultural season. It'll have a negative effect on the local economy for a long time. So at the moment, the communities that have been living around this area, if I understand right, many of the people in those communities have evacuated. Part of our mandate as the United Nations is to help with national reconciliation in this country. We're very active with the larger communities here. I want to make sure that we involve all the smaller communities as well, and the Kakai are one of those smaller communities. And of course they have a role to play in national reconciliation like the larger communities. One of the issues that's been raised with me today is the security situation here, which is very poor. There seems to have been a resurgence of Daesh activity here, and some of the Kakai communities have felt they have to leave their villages. So I'm speaking to them about the security situation, and we're speaking also to the federal police. Of course, this is not a problem unique to the Kakai. It's a very big problem for the whole of Kirkuk province, but I'm interested to understand how we as the UN can support the communities here in rebuilding their security. Iraq has an extraordinary richness of diversity in its religious communities, and I've been interested to hear today more about the Kakai community here in Kirkuk. We're visiting a number of areas that are of interest to them. We're visiting, just visited one of their cemeteries. Behind me is the burial mound of an important individual from a couple of hundred years ago. And I find walking around and talking to the prince of the Kakai a wonderful way into understanding a little bit more about this community and how they fit into the much wider tapestry of the individual religious communities in Iraq.
That's very cool. Oh, well, I'm pleasure to show you. Because, you know, you want to see the world.
I'm very interested in the history of your community here.
That's right.
Yes.
أنا سردار أرجمان فتاح آغا ممثل الكاكية بالعراق يعني ورئيس العام للكاكية احنا الكاكية لهم تاريخ عريق بهذا البلد يعني يوصل إلى أكثر من 900 عام تقريبا واحنا الكاكية موجود مناطقنا في كركوك داقوق وفي ديالة في منطقة خانقين وفي منطقة مندلي في بغداد أيضا موجود عوائل الكاكية موجودين في مناطق الكلك يم الموصل وفي أربيل قرى يعني قرى موجودة مثل هاي المنطقة احنا تعرضنا إلى عدة هجمات إرهابية خصوصا بعد 2003 من صار يعني من استفحل الإرهاب بالعراق حالنا حال كل العراقيين يعني دفعنا كثير من شبابنا بالشهداء انفجارات اغتيالات اشكال من يعني من المواضيع الارهابيه عدا ذاك هجرت القرى يم الموصل عندما جاء داعش وهنا همينا هاي المنطقه همينا هجرت بالاونه الاخيره وفي بدايه الاحداث ايضا 2014 قريه دمرت بالكامل عندنا قرى 6-7 قرى يم الموصل نفس الشيء هذا كان حالنا لحد الآن ونطالب الحكومة أنه تأمن الأماكن هاي كل الأماكن اللي تقدر عليها تأمنها عندنا قرى تهجرت بال 2014 دخول داعش من يم الموصل وهنا بكركوك بداقوق نفس الشيء تهجروا وبعد تدري بعد عمليات التحرير تهدمت هاي القرى وتأذت كثير وواي ناس انطينا شهداء يعني. وأكو قرى هسه يعني مثلا هاي القرية اللي هسه احنا واقفين بيها هاي صار لها أسبوعين من يعني طلعوا وتهجروا بسبب الوضع الأمني طبعا.
The security forces will be able to establish a presence here that will allow people to come safely back to their homes.